Hi, welcome to this last episode of building this electric guitar. In this last episode, I'll be finishing it and making the final assembly. First, I'm filling the grain of the mahogany back. The back is going to receive a black dye. I'm going to apply a second coat, but first I'll sand a little bit. The flame maple is going to receive a purple burst. With the same black dye, I'm darkening the edges. I'm using different rugs to apply the dye. With the purple rug, I'm blending the hard black edge. In order to obtain more grain deepness, I'll be sanding and dyeing two more times. I'm going to finish the guitar with nitrocellulose lacquer. But first, I'm going to throw 3 coats of sanding sealer, which I've forgotten to shoot. Here, I'm leveling the sealer. I'm using 320 grit. Next, I'm going to shoot 8 coats of lacquer. And 3 weeks later, I'll rub out the finish. I forgot to record the wet sanding, but I started with 1000 grit, then 1500, and finally with 2000. Then came the polishing process. I polished the lacquer in 3 stages. First with medium compound, then fine compound, and finally with a swirl remover. Of course, I'm polishing by hand. I'm using Stuart McDonald Color Tone Polishing Compounds. I'm padding with neoprene the Floyd Rose Reese's. The next step is to level the frets. In order to strike the neck, I'm Adjusting the Truss Rod. I'm going to protect the finish of the fingerboard with tape. And also the finish of the guitar. With this blue marker, I'm coloring the frets. And I'll be sanding with this beam until the blue marks disappear. Here I'm sanding a little fall away. And finally, I'm going to recrown and mirror polish each fret. I'm going to shield each cavity with this aluminium tape. Next, it's time to fit the tuning machines. Next, the locking nut. Next, the spring's claw. And next, the pickups. Now I'm going to hold them only with tape. No screws yet. Now it's time to solder the electronics. I'm using a 5-way P mega switch. and next I will install the pots and the knobs. And the jack plate. Now the holes for the back plate of the electronics. Now the time to string the instrument has arrived. In order to align the pickups, I'm going to install the two outer strings. Now I can attach them with the screws. At this point, the Floyd Rose is being held by a good wedge. Since there are no springs yet, this wedge is taking all the strings tension and keeping it at the right position. Then I loose the screws of the claw and attach the springs. And then with the tuned guitar, I tighten the screws until the wedge falls. Here we go. With the Floyd Rose adjusted, now I can screw the back plate. And this is the final step. The truss rod plate cover. Here you can see the finished instrument. Hope you enjoyed this series. If it's the case, don't forget to press thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Hopefully, I'll be uploading a demo video soon. Thanks for watching.